Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, make us worthy to celebrate the exaltation of your glorious cross. With sacred hymns and songs, when you appear on the last day, the sign of your cross will shine brighter than the sun. Gather us before you and surround us with your eternal light, that we may raise glory and thanks to you and to your Father and your Holy Spirit forever.
That we may
Accept these prayers in the fragrance of the incense that we have offered on the feast of the exaltation of your holy cross. May its signs always be visible before our eyes to strengthen us, that we may walk with you toward death, and then stand at your right hand to celebrate the eternal feast of your victory. We glorify you, your Father, in your Holy Spirit forever.
Amen.
So let us not grow weary in doing what is right, for we will reap
we have an opportunity, let us work for the good of all, and especially for those in the family of faith. Praise be to God always.
This is the truth, peace be with you.
the scriptures are written for situations in which we are understood to be slaves at some level or another. Maybe not literally, but we're all kind of slaves to something in our attitudes that jeopardize, sabotage who we are. Maybe we're too quick to speak or too slow to speak. But we do have a sense that life is not always fair. In this situation, first we have to understand and use it in a symbolic aspect. And that all of us have a view of who God is. And there's a wide variety of images of how we think of God. I remember when I was in Fayetteville, one of the parishioners who was a convert from being a Baptist, he was imagery of God when he was growing up was the hot furnace in the bottom of the basement that sent out black smoke every once in a while and was very frightening. Kind of like the story of Home Alone, where the guy, the little boy, has to conquer his fear of the furnace down in the basement. I remember growing up that every once in a while a black mark would show up on the calendar. And that might mean that my mother was trying to emphasize that our bad behavior is recorded somewhere in that book in heaven. And you didn't want to have too many places on the calendar with your initials in there. That worked for a little while until one of my older brothers was caught adding on to the list. But it's only our instinct to want to control bad behavior. And we use all types of ways of doing it. You know, some I remember also when I was in Fayetteville, you know, the parents of this little boy said, you know, that priest, you know, he represents God. And you better behave. Well, a couple of days later, we were outside, and I heard him yelling, "Hey, God." And I thought, that's pretty faithful, yelling for God to help him with something. Finally, he walks up to me and tugs on my sleeve and says, "Why won't you listen to me?" Now, I assure you, I am not God. Probably more similar to those little black marks on the calendar. But the good thing is if we repent, if we change our ways, they are erased. Because the scripture also says that may our sins be as scarlet, it is washed white as snow, and they are forgotten. Now, God cannot plead ignorance. So when we say forgotten, it means that they're not held against us. We will no longer be accused of those things. And when we do review, we'll see how lovingly and how compassionate God was in his forgiveness and the power of his forgiveness. And in this particular gospel, it doesn't seem fair that why did he give this one only one talent? Maybe he thought it was very unfair. And I say that because I'm sure all of us at different times in our life really feel that life has been unfair. Their talents given to them give them not the same advantages of someone else. And the truth is that life isn't fair. We are not handled all the same way. You know, what family hasn't had one sibling tease the other, saying that they are the favorite? Or teasing them that the other one's been adopted? All kinds of strange ways that we try to needle the other person. Or we don't realize it, but really, we do hurt other people in ways that we're not even aware that we have done it. We can go away thinking that God is always trying to catch us and putting black marks on the calendar, or like a scary furnace in the basement, ready to use us as energy to keep the flames going. Or we can have the image that the two slaves had, discovering that he is generous in what he gives. After all, it was a gift from him to give those talents. And for that one that only had one, it wasn't as if something that was his was taken away from him. The investment that God made in that person's life had been rejected, and he probably didn't even realize it. If we only can see our life in the negative, and there certainly is the negative, I'm not pretending it's not there, that there are harsh people, and that in some ways God does seem harsh in certain situations. However, this man never asked around. If he would have talked to these other two persons, there says, no, you know, God is a loving God. That yes, we can put ourselves into darkness, and we can tear each other apart and destroy each other. And we have to learn how to cope and deal with the power that we have to cause weeping and gnashing of teeth. But God did not create darkness, and he did not create weeping, and he did not create the gnashing of teeth. That is what we do when we pull further and further and further away from God. He allows us to have the free will. So I can't overemphasize how important it is in each day of our life to learn more and more about God. Because no matter how old we are, we can still deepen our level of understanding of who God is. There's a story that Saint Dominic, who has wrote great, tremendous theological books on the study of God, received a vision. And in seeing that vision, he said everything that he wrote was nothing but straw. Now that doesn't mean those books were nothing but straw and worthless, but it was a way of saying no matter how beautiful we may view God or the world around us, the beauty that God has is profoundly more than that. And that it's to our advantage to become a free person, to find our beauty in the eyes of God rather than arguing and fighting for it, for our status and position. There is another phrase in this gospel that I think is very powerful. Again, the imagery of fear. He was very afraid of the master. Now, fear isn't always bad. There's useful fear, and there's useless fear. There is things that we are showing a great sign of intelligence and wisdom when we fear certain things. But then again, there's also useless fear. And I think each day it's to our advantage to reflect which fears are controlling our life the most. Are we seeped in being controlled by what is useless or what is useful? Are we spending our life always gazing to want to attain a particular talent, hoping that finally that will make us happy? Are we learning how to accept who we really are, What is our actual talent in our gifts? And are we investing in them? The problem with this man who hid his talent, that he was controlled by fear. One, he had the wrong image of God operative in his life. And he probably had been rejecting and listening to people who may have had a deeper understanding of who God was. That somewhere along the line, he never put himself in a place to hear what was true and what to expect from the Master, so that one day he would dig it up, unfold the cloth that it was wrapped in, maybe realizing that he's never going to get happy envying the talents of someone else, or envying the position of someone else. We all go through this. It's even more difficult now when every single commercial is to emphasize that you don't have what it takes to be happy enough with what you already have. One talent is enough. If you invest in it, it will grow. It will prosper. You are not left with just one. And you might ask yourself, what might it be? And I'm very moved and touched by, and I'm sure I told this story before, about Saint Akitha, who was a slave in Africa, bought by an Italian wealthy man, brought to Italy, was set free. She became a nun. She came down with a very horrible illness where she was incapacitated. She could really actually do nothing. People had to wait on her. And a prince of the church, a cardinal, came to visit the convent one time. And the cardinal asked her, "What do you do?" And she said, "The same thing you do." The cardinal was very upset. How in the world could this woman, who had once been a slave, who could do nothing, lay in bed, possibly claim that she did the same thing he did? Finally, he asked her, and she said, "I'm doing the will of God." That always stuck in my mind because I'm sure there are times where we wish that we had a few extra talents so that we could do something maybe better than the person that we're jealous of, or at least belong to their particular group, or have as long an article written about them as the other. But those are traps. The reason they are traps is because sooner or later, you're going to bump into someone who can still do something better than you. Sooner or later, someone's going to forget your name. You haven't missed on the list. Something's not quite right. You're not at the prestigious table. Somehow you didn't get the promotion. Somehow you didn't get the attention you wanted. And then your life caves in. I know people who are resentful and angry over things that have happened 50 years ago because they won't look at true value. True talent is the ones that you have and been given to you already. And instead of bemoaning it, begin to learn how to rejoice and find meaning and joy and the gifts of others, and those gifts that have come from God, because all of those gifts added up make a beautiful, wonderful world. But if it's fear that controls, anger that controls, resentment and fear and more fear,
Expect a very destructive world, one that is shameful and embarrassing, and puts us in the darkness, causes us to weep, and causes us to gnash our teeth. All of this exists in the scriptures, and all of this exists in our personal lives, in the world around us. But we have a master who is loving and generous. He's not trying to find ways to take away from us. He's trying to find ways to give to us.
Through them all things were made. accept the offerings of our ancestors. Now accept these offerings that your children brought to you out of the love for you in your holy name. Shower spiritual blessings upon them, and place them the earthly gift. Grant them life in your kingdom.
Amen.
As we remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, in his plan of salvation for us, we recall upon his offering all those who please God from heaven to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, St. Mary, St. Joseph, and St. Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom the sacrifice is offered, for Selim and Namira. Remember also those who share with us today in this offering.
Thank you.
you the cherubim bless you, and the seraphim worship you, they cry out and proclaim, Kadoos.
Thank you.
and the prophets, holy angels, and the martyrs, and descend upon these mysteries and sanctify them. Ani Moria.
Thank you.
to stand before you and to call upon you with pure souls and clear consciences, praying.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Deliver us, O Lord, from every temptation and from the harm of evil. We have power over all, and we raise glory to you now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow your heads before the God of mercy, before his forgiving altar, and before the body and blood of our Savior, who gives life to those who partake of him and receive the blessing from the Lord.
O Lord, in your grace and abundant mercy, bless those who bow before you. Make us worthy to share your life-giving mysteries and to join the assembly of your saints, that with them we may raise glory to you and to your only Son and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most Holy Trinity, eternal consubstantial, be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit. Let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility and ask him for the mercy and compassion.
Holy gifts for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit, blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth. To him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by your holy body, and our souls purified by your forgiven blood. May our communion be forgiven of our sins, and
forgiven us your body to eat and your living blood to drink. O love of all people, have mercy on us.
Have mercy on us, O Lord. O compassionate and merciful one. O love of all people, have mercy on us.
Icon to give out. See the holy icon, may all the prayers be heard for vocations of the holy priesthood and religious life. In the name of the Father, the Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. And the raffle tickets are in a box in the back. Make sure you take them home with you, that they belong to your. Gracious God and Father, how can we repay you for your goodness for the salvation just given us? Who can give you the glory you truly deserve? In our weakness, insofar as we are able, we worship, praise, and thank you, your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Jesus Christ, our God, we worship, thank, and praise you. We implore your goodness and abundant mercy for the salvation of the whole world, for the protection of the living and eternal rest to the departed, for the feeding of the hungry and the support of the needy, for the visiting of the sick and the consolation of the grieving. Through your grace, draw them, and by your abundant mercy, give them life. By your cross, bless your people and protect your inheritance. Adoration due to you, to your Father,